John Borondungu is said to have been attacked and injured by his uncle over a land ownership dispute. According to Nyandarua OCPD Wilson Kosgei, the victim was rescued by police officers after he was found bleeding profusely and rushed to JM Kariuki Memorial Hospital, where he was treated and discharged. The bone of contention, according to the victim, is a 5-acre piece of land his mother bought from their late uncle.
Nilikojewa na niko yangu jana usiku. Kanianza kunipiga. Tuwa tunazania tu shamba. Imekaa muda juu hiyo shamba tulinunua ita 5. Sasa amekataa kutupatia title.
Kwa majina naitwa Steven Jalia. Jana jioni nisikia brothergu anapiga duru, nikaenda kuangalia ni nini. Nikapata anapigwa na aniko yangu akiwa chini. Kumuliza ni nini, aniko yangu hakuniambia. Mimi nikachukua brother yangu nikampeleka kwa nyumba. Alikuwa ameumia kichwa. Kichwa na uso kukatakatwa na axo.
Still in Olkalau, police have arrested two suspected fraudsters believed to be behind a group of swindlers conning locals of their hard-earned cash. According to Nyandarua Central OCPD Wilson Kosgei, the suspects Nicholas Maina Karanja and Joseph Maina, both from Milangine district, were targeting job seekers to secure employment.
So we were able to unmask them yesterday. And we have detained them. They'll appear in court tomorrow. And when they were searched, Joseph Maina was found with fake academic papers. The guy is a standard TET dropout, but he has a certificate of Form 4, which we believe, highly believe, that it is a dubious document.
Several SIM cards, an assortment of items used to make fake currency, a copy of KCSC certificate and school leaving certificates were found in their possession. Samson Kitavi, Lunchtime News.